Myself, my name is Saikal. I'm Max faculty in Velamala IT Foundation. Today's our topic is, graphs of trigonometric functions. Based upon graphs of the functions, we can say, some more topics and problems. Just here one of the, if sine theta is equal to k, if sine theta is equal to k, where k is positive, when we can get the k is positive means theta is lies between the first quadrant and second quadrant. If it is lies between the first quadrant and second quadrant, that means the theta value sum we are getting alpha over pi minus alpha. Why? Because just here once the theta value of alpha means we are getting the directly, it is in first quadrant. First quadrant we can take directly positive. Pi minus alpha. Pi minus alpha means nothing but, this is second quadrant. Second quadrant we are taking sine is positive. That's why pi minus alpha. Just here once the, if sine theta is equal to k, k is positive number means the angle is alpha comma pi minus alpha. Pi minus alpha. If k is negative, that means sine theta value we are getting negative. When we are getting the negative means, the theta is lies between third quadrant and fourth quadrant. Third quadrant means, the angle, it will be pi plus alpha or, if it is in fourth quadrant means 2 pi minus alpha. Why we are taking the pi and 2 pi only? That means every even multiple of 90 trigonometric function doesn't change. That means if you are taking sine pi plus alpha, pi plus alpha means third quadrant, we are getting third quadrant sine is the negative. That's why we are getting the negative answer. Understood? In the same way, 2 pi minus alpha. 2 pi means it is integral multiple of 90. Trigonometric function doesn't change. And we are getting that it is fourth quadrant. Fourth quadrant it will be negative. In the same way, if they are given cos theta is equal to k, cos theta is equal to k, cos theta is positive. When we are getting positive, that means cos theta is positive in which quadrant means first quadrant and fourth quadrant, first quadrant and fourth quadrant. That means k is positive means theta value we are taking either alpha or minus alpha also. Why? Because when we are taking the positive angle in first quadrant, if you are taking in negative, same angle in negative means that is in fourth quadrant only. Fourth quadrant only. Or what we can write? 2 pi minus alpha. 2 pi minus alpha also. 2 pi minus alpha also it is in nothing but fourth quadrant only. That means what are the, just here one of the, if cos theta is equal to k, cos theta is equal to k, then what are the, what are the angles we can take? Alpha minus alpha, 2 pi minus alpha. If k is negative means theta is belongs to second quadrant or third quadrant. Second quadrant or third quadrant. Second quadrant what we can take? Pi minus theta what we can take? Pi minus alpha we can take. Third quadrant means pi plus alpha we can take. Just here once of the, k is negative, that means cos theta is negative. When we can get cos theta is negative means some alpha value we are getting, it is k value, it is negative means pi minus alpha, pi plus alpha. In the same way, if tan theta is equal to k they are given, tan theta is equal to k they are given, if k is positive. Whenever k is positive, when we can take it that k is positive means tan theta is positive, when we can get either it is in first quadrant and third quadrant. That means theta value is in first quadrant. That means directly alpha we are taking in first quadrant. And third quadrant. Third quadrant means or we can take pi plus alpha. Pi plus alpha. That means we are getting tan theta is positive. In the same way, just here k is negative. K is negative. When we are getting the tan theta is negative means it is in second quadrant and fourth quadrant. Second quadrant it is negative and fourth quadrant it is negative. That means theta is nothing but what we can write, either second quadrant or fourth quadrant. Second quadrant means pi minus alpha we can take. Fourth quadrant means 2 pi minus alpha we can take. Okay, that is nothing but just here once observe. Okay, tan theta is equal to 4 by 3. Okay, sorry, tan theta is equal to minus 1. Tan theta is equal to minus 1. Tan theta is equal to minus 1 means tan is negative. Tan is negative. Okay. Tan is negative in which quadrant? Second quadrant and fourth quadrant. Second quadrant and fourth quadrant. Forget the sign. What is the value they are given? Tan theta. Theta is equal to 1 we are taking. Sorry, tan alpha we are taking. Tan alpha is equal to 1. That means, okay, forget the sign, whatever it is, tan alpha we are getting 1. What is alpha in first quadrant is 45 degrees. We know tan 45 value is 1. That means alpha value is 45 degrees. Okay, we want to find a tan theta value here. Theta is in second quadrant or fourth quadrant. Second quadrant, what we are getting? Okay, pi minus alpha. Pi minus alpha. Pi minus alpha. Pi means 180 degrees minus, nothing but. 180 degrees minus 45, 180 degrees minus 45 means 135 degrees. That is, theta value is either 135 degrees or, okay, fourth quadrant. Fourth quadrant means 2 pi minus alpha. 2 pi minus alpha means 360 minus 45. 360 minus 45 is 315 degrees. That means theta value either 315 degrees or 135 degrees. Tan theta is minus 1. Okay. Okay. When you observe the next example, secant x is equal to minus 13 by 5. Okay, here the x value is rise between minus 3 pi by 2 to minus 5. Okay, minus 5 radians. Then we have to find all other trigonometric ratios. Nothing but just here once of the 3 pi by 2 to minus 5 means it is which quadrant? 3 pi by 2 to okay minus 5 means it is in which quadrant? Which quadrant means nothing but just here once of the when you take here it is 0, it is minus pi by 2, this is minus pi, okay, this is minus 3 pi by 2 radians, 3 pi by 2 radians, okay, just here minus 3 pi by 2 to pi means, okay, it is rise in second quadrant, what are positive means sine and cosecant are positive, the remaining are negative, that's why secant x is negative, okay, secant x is negative. What is secant x? Ratio means hypotenuse by adjacent. Okay, that is, they are given minus 13 by 5. Forget the sign. We can take the trigonometric ratios in right angle triangle. Okay, forget the sign. Okay, whenever it is right angle, this is become hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is 13. When we are taking the angle axis here, okay, then this will become adjacent. This will become opposite. When you take this is adjacent, means this is 5. By using Pythagoras theorem, we can do means we can get 12. I am writing directly, we are getting the 12. Okay, then we want to find all other trigonometric ratios. Already we discussed the same question in previously also. Okay, we want sine x means opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite by hypotenuse, opposite is 12 and hypotenuse is 13. Sine x is rise between second quadrant sine is positive, directly we are getting 12 by 13 only. We want cos x is nothing but reciprocal of secant x. We can write the reciprocal of secant x is 5 by 13. Here cos x is second quadrant negative, then we are getting negative answer minus 5 by 13. Okay, we want tan x means opposite by adjacent we can write, or we can write sine x by cos x we can write means, okay, we can write sin x by cos x, or we can write opposite by adjacent also. Opposite by adjacent we can write under tan x. X is related to second quadrant. Sorry, tan x is there in second quadrant. It is negative. Then we are getting the negative answer. Okay. Or we can write like this also. 12 by 13 whole by minus 5 by 13. When you simplify this one means minus 12 by 5 we can get. Okay. In the same way, cot x. Cot x means reciprocal of tan x. Reciprocal of tan x is minus 5 by 12. In the same way, we want cosecant x is nothing but reciprocal of sine. Reciprocal of sine we can write means 13 by 12. 12 cosecant x is positive in second quadrant. We are getting the positive answer only. Next example, if secant theta minus tan theta is equal to 3, then we have to find theta is belongs to which quadrant. Okay, just here one of the, we know one of the trigonometric identity related to secant and tan. What we know, secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. By using that trigonometric identity, we know another formula, secant theta plus tan theta. Secant theta plus tan theta is equal to 1 by secant theta minus tan theta. Okay, 1 by secant theta minus tan theta, that is secant theta minus tan theta is, they are given 3. That means secant theta plus tan theta is equal to 1 by 3. Okay, what is the thing they are given? We can write directly secant theta minus tan theta is equal to 3. When you add these two, tan theta become cancel. Then 2 secant theta is equal to 1 by 3 plus 3. Okay, then mean 2 secant theta is equal to, when you simplify this one, is 10 by 3. Okay, we want secant theta, means secant theta is equal to 10 by 3 into 2. 2 table here it is 5 times, that means secant theta is equal to 5 by 3. Secant theta is equal to 5 by 3. Secant theta is 5 by 3. When you simplify this one, we are getting tan secant theta, we can substitute in this one. Okay, from given thing, what is given thing? Okay, given that what is given, secant theta minus tan theta is equal to 3. Secant theta is 5 by 3 minus tan theta is equal to 3. Tan theta will send to this side and 3 will send to this side, means tan theta is equal to 5 by 3 minus 3. Okay, then tan theta is equal to, what you are getting means minus 4 by 3. When you simplify that one, we are getting minus 4 by 3. Secant theta, what you are getting? Therefore, secant theta is equal to 5 by 3. Tan theta is equal to minus 4 by 3. Just here once of the, okay. When you simplify this one, means secant theta, what we are getting? 5 by 3. Tan theta, what we are getting? Minus 4 by 3. That means, when you take the angle, okay, secant become positive, tan become negative. Secant is positive in first and fourth quadrant. Okay, secant is positive in first and fourth quadrant. If you take it is in theta is in first quadrant, secant is positive, tan is positive, but tan is negative. Okay, once you can observe, secant positive, tan negative in which quadrant means fourth quadrant. That means theta must be belongs to fourth quadrant. Okay. And the next example, find the number of solutions of x in the interval 0 to 2 pi. That is nothing but in between the four quadrants. Okay, that satisfies the equation tan x plus secant x is equal to 2 cos x. Okay, it's okay. This equation satisfies what are the x values in between the interval 0 to 2 pi. What are they? They are asking. Just here once of the, what is the equation they are given? Tan x plus secant x is equal to 2 cos x. Okay, can I write tan x can be sin x by cos x plus secant x, we can write as 1 by cos x. 1 by cos x, then it is nothing but 2 cos x. We can write. Okay, when you take the LCM, then what you are getting means sin x plus 1 by cos x is equal to 2 cos x. Okay, cos x will send to that side, means it is in multiplication. Then what you are getting? Sin x plus 1 is equal to 2 cos square x. We can convert the cos square x into sin square x. How we can convert means by using first trigonometric identity, sin square x plus cos square x is equal to 1. Then cos square x is equal to, what we can write means 1 minus sin square x. That means what you can write? Sin x plus 1 is equal to 2 into 1 minus sin square x. When you simplify this one, what you are getting? Sin x plus 1 is equal to 2. When you multiply 2 inside, 2 sin square x. Okay, these two will send to this side. Then what you are getting? Okay, what you are getting means 2 sin square x, okay, plus sin x minus 1, which is equal to 0. Okay, it is okay. Just we can take put sin x is equal to a. Put sin x is equal to a, then it is looking like a 2a square plus a minus 1 is equal to 0. It is looking like a quadratic equation. We can solve the quadratic equation by factorization. Okay, when you split the middle term, then what you can get? 2a square, okay, I can split into 2a minus a, minus 1 is equal to 0. When you take 2a is common, then here a plus 1, when we are taking minus 1 is common, then it will become a plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, then we are getting a plus 1 is common, when we are taking a plus 1 is common, 2a minus 1 is equal to 0. That means a is equal to, a plus 1 is equal to 0, we can get, or 2a minus 1 is equal to 0. That means a is equal to minus 1, or a is equal to 1 by 2. A is equal to 1 by 2. Okay. A is equal to 1 by 2. Okay. What is a means? Sin x. Sin x is minus 1. Okay. Sin x is minus 1. And sin x is equal to 1 by 2. Okay. Just here once of the x interval, what we can get? 0 to pi. What are the x values we are getting? Minus 1. What are the x values we are getting? Minus 1. Just here once of the, okay, sine 90 value is 1. Okay, sine 90 value is 1. Okay, next sine which value is, okay, minus 1. Okay, in between the interval, just here once of the, in between the interval 0 to 2 pi, sine which value is minus 1 means, okay, sine x value minus, 3 pi by 2 radians. That means 270 degrees. 270 degrees, when you take the 270 degrees, what we can get? Okay, we are getting minus 1. We are getting minus 1. Okay, still anything? Okay, we didn't get that. Next, sin x is 1 by 2. Sin x is 1 by 2. Sin x is 1 by 2, for which I am? Okay, sin is positive. Okay, sin is positive. Okay, sin is positive. Sin is positive in which quadrant? First quadrant and okay, second quadrant. First quadrant and second quadrant. Sin which angle is 1 by 2? We are getting means sin 30 is 1 by 2. That means x value we are taking sin 30. Sin 30 means pi by 6 radians. Pi by 6 radians. Okay, we are getting the x value we want to take in second quadrant means we told okay, whenever the sin x is equal to k, k is positive means we are taking the angles x is equal to either k or pi minus k. That means we are taking the second quadrant means pi minus pi by 6 radians. Pi minus pi by 6 radians means pi by 6 radians. Okay, that means what are the x values it is satisfied means x is equal to 3 pi by 2 radians we can take, that is nothing but x value sin x value minus 1. Okay, in this interval, okay, here only we are getting the minus 1. In the same way, x is equal to pi by 6 radian. Pi by 6 radian means we are getting 1 by 2. Okay, in the same way, 1 by 2, if it is in second quadrant also sin x is positive. That's why we are getting 5 pi by 6 radians. Okay, in this interval, we are getting these values. What are the x values you can get means x is equal to pi by 6 radians and 5 pi by 6 radians and 3 pi by 2 radians. Okay, these x values satisfy this equation. Okay, that means they are asking number of solutions of x. Number of solutions of x, okay, it satisfied 0 to 2 pi. 2 pi means here 3 solutions are there. That means number of solutions are 3. Thank you.